If you see another person that looks identical to you, run away and hide.
Welcome to Paranormal Nightshift, your home for all things that go bump in the dark and your fan stories told here.
Today's story comes from Jess and Catherine and is called The Doppelganger.
My husband and I both worked crazy schedules. Both of us were on night shift, but both of us were on different rotations, so we only ever really saw each other throughout the day. It was kind of a weird schedule, but at the time it was what we had to do to be able to make everything work. He'd come home and I'd be asleep on the couch, or I'd come home and he'd be asleep on the couch, vice versa. It was what it was for the time, and it didn't leave a lot of time for mommy and daddy alone time.
I hate to say it, but you should never get to that point in a relationship to where you can't remember the last time that you were actual intimate with your partner. But needless to say, we were going through a dry spell.
So we decided to make a conscious effort to try to fix that. I was ready to start a family. I knew that once we had a baby, I could find a new job and everything would kind of go to the way we wanted it to be. We started scheduling our little hookup sessions. But during the course of our sessions is when we started noticing weird things. Our time frames and our actual times of seeing each other didn't seem to add up anymore. Like I said, we worked a night shift and it was just the two of us, but he would come into the bedroom during the day and we would have our fun time.
Just after to have fun time to find him asleep on the couch. He said the same thing was happening to him. He would be asleep on the couch or in the bed, and I would come in ready to have fun time. Just for him to be in the same situation to where I wasn't where I was supposed to be after the fun time happened.
It would be before work or after work, and then our days off were always completely different. But once we started doing math and actually having conversations with each other, we realized that both of us had days that the other one didn't know happened. As in, it happened, but there's no way it happened with the other person. Now yes, when you work night shift, you do lose track of what day it is. Night shift's the only people that work yesterday, today, and tomorrow, all in the same 24-hour period. But there were certain dates that just didn't add up. We both felt so dirty and violated. We knew what we had experienced. We were there with that person, but that person wasn't there.
And then we started talking about other places and other things that we had did where the other person wasn't there at all. He had had full lunches and dinners with me while I was at work. And I had had full lunches and dinners and showers and intimate time with him while he was at work. We realized that we were dealing with something far more paranormal than what we thought.
We decided that we needed a code word, a text or something. Something that we were just going to text each other. That way it would never feel dirty and violated. I can't explain to you how weird the whole situation felt. But one day, I was on the couch and he was in the kitchen making a sandwich. Something about him just felt off. I asked him the code word and he looked at me like I was silly. Like, what are you talking about? We don't have a code word. Whatever you are, I need you out of my house. Get out of my house. He didn't know the code word. I was speaking to something that looked like my husband and looked just like him and acted like him, but it was like they had forgotten everything that we had talked about. The whole goal behind all of this was to become pregnant, and I'm kind of concerned and happy to announce that I am, but our time frames aren't adding up. We were dealing with something paranormal and now I've become pregnant. And I don't know if it's 100% my husband's or whatever this doppelganger might be.
No thank you. No thank you at all. The idea that something paranormal could come into your everyday life and look just like somebody you truly care for, and then you share intimate encounters with whatever that was. Oh, that's a different level of feeling violated and feeling dirty that I can't even think about that one. Tell me in the comments what you thought about this story.